Good evening and welcome to the State of the City for the City of Goleta. I'm Valerie Kushnerov, the Community Relations Manager for the City, and on behalf of the City Council and staff, we are pleased you are here this evening. Tonight we will have a presentation by Mayor Paula Perotti, followed by our My Goleta video. Then City Manager Michelle Green will give an overview of the City's finances, and we'll end the evening with our housing overview. But before we dive in, I'd like to introduce our Goleta City Council. Mayor Paula Perotti. Mayor Pro Tempore Stuart Kasdan, in the back. Councilmember Michael T. Bennett, who is on his way. Councilmember Kyle Richards. And Councilmember Roger Aceves, who was unable to be here this evening. I would also like to thank several people and organizations who helped make this event possible. The Goleta Valley Community Center, Scott Phillips from Synergy Computing, Tad Clark and Jack Woods from AMS Entertainment, Tony Ruggieri for our video recording, Sylvia Uribe, who is providing our Spanish translation, and Goleta Nothing Bundt Cakes, which provided the buntinis in the back. So if you haven't helped yourself, I hope you will do so. Now I'd like to welcome up our mayor, Paula Perotti.
Thank you, Valerie. And thank you for this opportunity to present the State of Goleta to this distinguished group of people that live, work, and play in this wonderful city of ours. On this 15th anniversary of our cityhood, I'm happy to report that the state of our city is strong. Just during my, in case you didn't notice, just during my mayorship, precipitation is well up over 200% from last year. Our drought is on the wane, and our farmers are relieved. Unemployment and crime are low. Housing and commercial real estate are in high demand, a strong indicator that people want to live and work in Goleta. Our growing hotel occupancy is a good indicator that people want to visit and play here. I want to start by reviewing some of our key accomplishments during these first 15 years. And please bear with me, this is a long list, it is 15 years. So here we go. To begin, let's give credit to our first Goleta City Council members. Jean Blois, Margaret Connell, Cynthia Brock, Jack Hawkshurst, and Johnny Wallace. Who started us, he really got us started, staffing up, drafting a general plan, and holding those first meetings, some of which were held right here in this room. I believe it might have been Neil Sedaka who said something like, starting up is hard to do. Starting up while trying to run a city must have been like trying to change a tire on a moving car. Had to be difficult. Today, as a result of the efforts of the first and succeeding city councils and staff, Goleta has been named among the top 10 best places to live in multiple publications. This is due in large part to our commitment to public safety. Goleta has been named one of the safest cities in California 4 times. Over 260 volunteers have been trained as members of our community emergency response team. This includes 70 Spanish-speaking CERT members and the first Train the Trainer program in Spanish in the United States. We've made progress on the construction of Fire Station 10. Adding the station will allow for a quicker response to emergencies on the western end of Goleta and free up personnel at the other stations to respond more quickly as well. We're grateful for our community partners who have helped us in our efforts to improve public safety. I'm going to single out only 2 of the many individuals who have given extraordinary service to Goleta, and I hope the rest will forgive me for not thanking them by name. Thanks to the generosity of Mark Linehan, owner of the Camino Real Marketplace, the city has been able to invest over $1 million for public safety since 2008. Most recently, the city purchased an H2S detector for Fire Station 11. This will help fire personnel more swiftly identify the source of questionable odors, which tend to occur on the western end of Goleta. Through a partnership with Marburg and John Price, the city has created an emergency communications trailer that is deployed to various locations within the city to provide real-time public information during emergencies. The city has made other safety improvements through capital improvement projects, such as the San Jose Creek Improvement Project, as well as many Old Town projects. We're well along the process to provide a safer bike lane for children attending Elwood School, and construction is beginning. Another project, the roundabout at Los Caneros and Cay Real, not only showed Goleta drivers the virtues of a traffic circle, the circle earned the city an American Public Works Association Award for Transportation Project of the Year. And the city replaced the Cathedral Oaks Bridge and the Los Caneros Overhead Bridge as part of the robust capital improvement program that has 57 projects worth $146 million. We also added numerous pedestrian improvements, including those at Fairview and Berkeley, Santa Margarita and Cathedral Oaks, and along Hollister Avenue in Old Town. The Planning and Environmental Review Department has several key initiatives underway. The Historic Preservation Project will provide an inventory of historic resources within the city and create a citywide historic context statement. Work continues on creating a new zoning ordinance that better reflects the city's general plan. Having received valuable input through dozens of meetings, we expect to release a draft ordinance at the end of this summer for public review. We are committed to providing ample opportunity for public review and feedback before the final ordinance is adopted. Of course, fiscal stability is also vital to our city. 2012, our 10th year, was significant for the city's budget for several reasons that have carried forward to the present. First, we saw an increase in the percentage of sales and bed tax the city retains. The city now keeps 70% of its sales tax and 100% of the bed tax, significantly improving our finances. Then we saw the passage of Measure H, which increased the revenue we received from hotel stays from 10% to 12%. On the downside, 2012 was also the first year we were grappling with the loss of redevelopment funds, taking away $3 million annually for projects such as the San Jose Creek Project, the Old Town Park, and other revitalization efforts. The challenge that loss created continues. We are prudent with your tax dollars and are transparent in our processes. For the last 12 years, the city has received an award of excellence in financial reporting. This prestigious award is given to cities preparing financial reports that provide full disclosure well beyond the minimum requirements. Several significant economic development efforts over the past 15 years have been successfully initiated. The city's economic development coordinator works closely with businesses, UCSB, and the Goleta Chamber to support regionally economic vitality. We also encourage and assist entrepreneurs and companies to start or expand their businesses in Goleta. In 2012, the city prepared partners with the Chamber and the University to establish GEM, the Goleta Entrepreneurial Magnet Program, to support new and growing entrepreneurs. Over the years, GEM has supported 12 new startups, five of which have either launched, been acquired, or are still active. GEM continues to focus on attracting technology startups with high potential to expand their footprint in the Goleta area. For the past several years, the city has supported visitor serving services through an agreement with the Goleta Chamber and Visit Santa Barbara, the official travel resource for the Santa Barbara South Coast. Our city manager, Michelle Green, will elaborate on the successes of these efforts during her presentation this evening. To provide more recreational opportunities, we've made many park and open space improvements and have several others in the works. We've benefited from the beautiful Gersh Park and are enjoying the opportunity to skate at Ice in Paradise. Through a huge community effort in 2004, the Sperling Preserve on the Elwood Mesa was acquired and set aside for the public enjoyment forever. What a wonderful community treasure and a great opportunity it is to be able to see the monarch butterflies that migrate through Goleta annually. The city has also purchased 5 open space parcels along the Elwood Mesa and plans to acquire the remaining 12 parcels to preserve these lands for future generations. Finally, we've made great strides in our sustainability efforts and are proud to be certified green business. The city received 2 Beacon Spotlight Awards for sustainability efforts and Public Policy Leadership Award for efforts in the area of green buildings, sustainable living on the Central Coast. We've adopted a green building program, adopted LEED Silver standards for the new city-owned buildings, and we've worked with Camino Real and Nissan USA to install a fast-charging electric vehicle station in the marketplace. Along with our accomplishments, it's important to acknowledge that our city also faces some challenges. Like other cities and counties nationwide, we are dealing with issues such as jobs, crime, environmental protection, housing, and yes, even hunger and homelessness. I do want to identify just a few of the challenges immediately before us. As you may know, our professional staff includes several key staff vacancies as personnel move on to new adventures. We have filled our city attorney position on an interim basis with the firm of Jenkins and Hogan and expect to have a new finance director and planning and environmental review director on board within the next month. A new deputy city manager should be appointed shortly thereafter. We're determined to find adequate funding for Goleta's library and possibly even expand the services we've come to rely on. The city is embarking on changing from city council, citywide elections to district elections, and will begin the district mapping process in 2021. In the meantime, we are launching a Goleta Public Engagement Commission to make recommendations on how we can encourage residents to get more involved in local government. And in 2018, voters will directly elect a mayor for a 2-year term, changing from the former system of city council appointing the mayor. The news about Venico's bankruptcy and returning of its asset to the State Lands Commission has its challenges and opportunities as well. While we are hopeful about the restoration of Elwood Onshore facility to an active recreation area, it will take time and money. Our priority will be to ensure the decommissioning process protects public safety and the environment, and we will keep the public informed of developments. We have other ambitious goals, such as improving transportation, achieving a permanent city hall, increasing our revenue base, and creating a proper Goleta train depot. And that's just a little of what we are looking forward to addressing in the near future. Perhaps one of our biggest challenges is this: how, as we work on 2017 challenges, how do we strategically position our community for long-term success? I believe that one of the key success factors is a continued focus on improving our economic environment. Doing so will not only provide opportunities for our children to stay in our communities, a stronger economic base will also encourage our tax revenues so we can provide services we all need: updated infrastructure, public safety, libraries, parks, social services, and affordable, reliable, and sustainable supplies of clean water and energy. But to be absolutely clear, I am committed to improving our economic environment by constantly protecting and enhancing our community character and quality of life, not by diminishing it. And I'm going to repeat it again, so make sure that you hear it. To absolutely clear, I am committed to improving our economic environment by constantly protecting and enhancing our community character and quality of life, not by diminishing them. I believe what's good for our environment and neighborhoods is good for our economy. I believe we need to focus on four key drivers to boost the city's economic expansion and vitality. First, we must manage traffic and parking and good roads so people want to come and shop here. But at the same time, we must also promote transportation alternatives and work harder on public transit, biking accessibility, pedestrian safety, as well as flex hours and telecommuting. By doing so, the city will promote a healthy environment by protecting air quality, reducing greenhouse gas emissions, and utilizing a comprehensive approach to sustainable practices for the benefit of future generations. Second, we must protect our natural beauty and environment, such as our scenic views, the Butterfly Preserve, local beaches, Elwood Mesa, while continuing to preserve the character of Goleta's neighborhoods. Third, we must ensure public safety with sufficient police and fire, but also with dependable, safe, and affordable supplies of clean water and energy. And fourth, we must continue to work on housing affordability. This starts with evaluating the effects of the thousands of new units currently being built, not just in Goleta, but in the surrounding areas, especially at UCSB. How do we expect to step up to our near-term challenges and achieve these long-term strategic objectives? As some of you may have heard me say before, I draw inspiration and perspective by thinking back 100 years to 1917. Then, our leaders faced enormous challenges. War in Europe, widespread poverty, diseases such as polio, women's voting rights, and equal rights for minorities. Workers sought an 8-hour day and safe work conditions, while our nation faced the Industrial Revolution, a significant transition from horses to cars and from handwork to assembly lines. With leadership and widespread participation, our nation exceeded any realistic goals it might have set for itself at the dawn of the 20th century. We electrified our cities, created a transportation systems that took us first to all 50 states and then eventually to the moon. We conquered major diseases, reduced elder poverty through a social security system, and we split the atom. We integrated our armed forces and made major strides towards social and economic opportunity. We did all this and more despite a great flu epidemic, a nationwide depression, two world wars, and the Korea and Vietnam actions. And by the end of the 20th century, we replaced adding machines with computers that we now carry in our pockets, welcoming the internet, well, mostly, ushering in an entirely new social and economic dimensions. History shows that consistently, our reach has exceeded our grasp. You may say, the past is past. How do we meet these challenges today? I and my fellow council members say, we do it the old-fashioned way. We do it together. Not just with experienced council members and talented staff, but also by engaging individuals and organizations. We are blessed with a population full of skilled and well-educated individuals. We have a diverse economy, with vibrant small businesses and thriving agriculture. We have tremendous environmental resources, the beaches, mountains, ocean, and butterflies. We have a low crime and unemployment rate. Our resources and opportunities are the envy of other communities. We are still at the dawn of this 21st century. So let us draw our inspiration from the vast and dizzying accomplishments of those who came before us over the past 100 years. Let's resolve to be similarly bold and ambitious. Let's work together to lay the foundation for another quantum leap into this 21st century. Let's remember that when we work together, we can make today's challenges tomorrow's accomplishments. Let's reaffirm that when good leadership is matched with community-wide participation, our reach can indeed exceed our grasp. For a better and brighter future for everyone in this very special community that we call home. Thank you. Thank you. Now let's watch our My Goleta video.
My Goleta is cool nights.
And warm days.
It's walking my kids to school.
And watching for new growth.
Goleta is sending love to the moon and back.
And shipping the good lands around the world.
Goleta means losing our way and finding our path.
Goleta is a great place to raise our family.
And has everything I need to keep them safe.
Goleta, it's serving its unique flavor.
And bringing our community together.
It's honoring the legacy of our past.
And looking toward our bright future.
Goleta's technology
is out of this world.
And down to earth, supporting our local economy with great jobs.
Goleta is working where I live.
And living where I work.
It's brewing with culture.
Goleta is my town.
Goleta is mi ciudad.
Goleta is our town!
Experience Goleta.
Time I see that video, I get chills. It brings a tear to my eye. Did you all love that video as much as I did? Yes? Well, I'd like to recognize the work of Valerie Kushneroff, our community relations manager, whose beautiful script and vision were realized in that video. Let's give her a round of applause as well. Thank you. I'd also like to thank Jamie Shaw, our community relations assistant, who helped with the scheduling and the filming and getting all the participants together. Great job, Jamie. Thank you as well. Let's give her a round of applause, too. This video makes me feel so proud to live and to work in Goleta. We really do have a wonderful and unique community that we should be very, very proud of. But today, I'm pleased to present the state of Goleta's financial outlook to you. First, I'd like to recognize the city staff that are in attendance tonight. So I'll be calling their names. If they could stand or raise their hands so you can see who they are. Most of them are behind you, by the way. First of all, we have Vito Adamitis, our Neighborhood Services and Public Safety Director in the back there. And we have Lisa Prossi up front, our Interim Planning and Environmental Review Director. In the back, we have Rosemary Gaglione, our Public Works Director. Right next to Rosemary, we have Luke Rio, our Interim Finance Director. And once again, we've got Valerie Kushneroff here, our Community Relations Manager. In the back corner, we have Todd Mitchell, our HR and risk manager.
And up front here, we have Mr. Jaime Valdez, our Economic Development Coordinator. And Jamie Shaw was in the back. I don't see her now, but she's still there. Anyway, let's give Jamie Shaw another round of applause. There she is. Well, everyone is probably curious. It's June now, and you're wondering about our budget process. Well, I'm pleased to report the development process for our next two-year budget is well underway. The City Council held four workshops this month with the goal of adopting the budget in June, so we're well on the way to that goal. We have several big issues before us. While our revenue base remains strong and our operations are lean, the demands on the city have increased. Thankfully, the city is not seeing the degree of pension cost increases that older and larger cities with public safety employees are facing. So that's a very good thing. However, there are many needs the council would like to address in the coming years. These include significant investment in our roads. Now, anyone who has driven in Goleta lately knows many of our roads are in need of repair. The volume of rain that we received in a short period last winter really took a toll on our streets. In addition, these roadways weren't really designed for the volume and the weight of the vehicles that travel on them every day. So the council recently voted to allocate funds this spring to begin paving key arterials throughout the city, but this is just the start of what is needed. We also have 55 capital improvement projects with a value of $146 million. These projects are important as the city strives to serve the needs of our public. And many of these projects are actually in Old Town. The Equal Road Extension Project, the Hollister Complete Streets Corridor Project, and the Old Town Sidewalk Project, just to name a few. But this steep price tag, combined with our small staff, make it a challenging program to implement while balancing all of the city's priorities. The City Council also has a desire to take over management of the Goleta Library, as our mayor mentioned in her speech. We're in discussions with the City of Santa Barbara and the County of Santa Barbara as both agencies play a role in the Goleta Library. Funding for libraries has dwindled statewide, and there is no easy solution to the fiscal challenges of running a library, but we will continue to work hard on this issue. The Council recently heard a report on the condition of the Goleta Valley Community Center building where we are this evening. And the council's committed to making improvements to make this a vibrant place for the community to continue to gather. But again, funding a major project like this will take careful thought and prudent planning. Finally, it's critical that the city's fiscal stability, that we maintain a healthy contingency reserve while also balancing the community's various needs. But despite these challenges, our financial outlook remains positive. And over the past 15 years, the city's revenue has increased steadily. And through the very prudent fiscal policies enacted by our City Council, we have built a healthy contingency reserve fund, which is projected to be at $8.7 million by the end of the fiscal year. As you'll see in the following slides, our revenues have risen primarily due to increased transient occupancy tax, or TOT, sales tax, and property tax, which together make up 81% of the city's total revenues. TOT leads the top three at 33%, while sales tax and property tax come in at 25% and 23%, respectively. The following chart shows in dollars what the top three generators contribute to the city's revenue stream. TOT revenues were almost $8.2 million in fiscal year 15-16 and have climbed to a projected $8.7 million for the current fiscal year. Over the last 3 years, we've seen increases in our TOT. In fiscal year 12-13, to 13-14, we saw an increase of 24.5%. The next fiscal year, we saw an 11.9% increase, and then a 4.71% increase in 2016. Now, while this data reflects a potential flattening trend for TOT, we're still projecting modest increases for the next fiscal year due to the Marriott Residence Inn and the Hilton Garden Inn opening soon. Sales tax experienced an increase as well, going from $6.2 million in 15-16 to a projected $6.7 million by the end of the current fiscal year. Despite this growth in sales tax, the city remains conservative in its projections for future years. We're all seeing the impact of online sales on traditional brick and mortar retailers. A change in the retail landscape means shifts in sales tax allocations, and the city is carefully monitoring these fluctuations as it projects future revenues. Property tax is expected to increase slightly this year, rising to just over $6 million. This can be attributed in part to the increase in assessed valuations through recent sales tax transactions. Goleta's low inventory of available housing, combined with a strong demand for housing overall on the South Coast, have raised the median income price here. The median home price here. The city supports visitor services as a vibrant part of our economy through partnerships with the Goleta Valley Chamber of Commerce and Visit Santa Barbara. By working with these organizations, the city continues to see healthy TOT and growth in the sales tax revenue generated in local eateries. In addition, the city's support of local events through our own Goleta City Grant Program helped bring people to great events and activities in our community, such as the Old Town Christmas Parade, the World of Pinot Noir, the Lemon Festival, Fiesta Ranchera, and other events at Rancho La Patera and Stowe House, and the 4th of July Fireworks Festival at Gersh Park, to name just a few. As a result, 1/3 of the city's total revenue is generated by TOT. The average daily rate, or ADR, and occupancy rates fluctuate seasonally but are still consistently high in Goleta. In 2016, the average daily rate for hotel stays in Goleta was nearly $168, which represents a 3.3% increase over 2015. The revenue per available room, or RevPAR, for Goleta was $135 in 2016, which represents about a 3% increase over 2015. Occupancy rates were at 80% on average in 2016, which is very positive news. In the hospitality industry, occupancy rates of 65% and over are considered to be high. It's very interesting to note that ADR, occupancy, and RevPAR in Goleta were extremely high last summer and were higher here than in the overall area. In fact, they were the highest seen in the area in all of 2015 and 2016. These trends reflect a demand for overnight stays in Goleta that is not solely tourism-based, but stems from local business and UCSB as well. In addition to all of the people who want to visit Goleta, there are other indicators which reflect a healthy local economy for those who live and work here. The unemployment rate is currently at 2.6%, which is a decrease over the 2016 unemployment rate of 3.3%. The Federal Reserve considers a base unemployment rate of 5 to 5.2% to be full unemployment, so we're doing well. In addition, Goleta's unemployment rate is currently lower than any of the other cities in Santa Barbara County. In the area of commercial real estate, Goleta currently has vacancy rates of 11.8% for office space, 2.2% for retail space, and 1.6% for industrial space, which all reflects decreases in vacancy rates over the 2016 calendar year. Goleta continues to be a desirable place to do business, and that is one of the factors that keeps our vacancy rates low. So as you leave tonight, I hope you remember this. The state of the city is very positive. Our dedicated and professional staff is managing a multitude of projects to serve our community better. I'm proud to lead these efforts and proud to be living here and raising my family in this community. We'll hope you'll engage with us as we move these items forward for the benefit of Goleta. Thank you.
Thank you, Michelle. So now we'll move on to housing. Housing seems to be a hot topic in Goleta. Questions are popping up about why so many new housing units are being built, where the water is coming from, and who these housing units are serving. Business owners are asking how to attract and retain a highly qualified workforce with a high cost of housing. Middle-aged families are wondering how to keep their aging parents in town, and parents are hoping their children will be able to buy a place to raise their families. In the next 12 minutes, we'll provide a snapshot of housing within the city limits. First, we have Jaime Valdez, Economic Development Coordinator for the City of Goleta.
Good evening, everyone. Over the last 15 years, the city has partnered with a number of developers for affordable housing. These include 34 units at Sumida Gardens for very low and moderate renters. The Hideaways has 10 townhomes for purchase. The Willow Creek project offered 2 moderate income townhomes, and Mountain View Ranch had 8 very low income townhomes for purchase as well. In addition, the city worked with community partners to develop housing for special needs adults at Braddock House in Old Town. This project brought 4 very low rentals for developmentally disabled adults. In a minute, we'll hear from John Fowler from People Self-Help Housing about their projects. But looking forward, we have the Mariposa project, which is an assisted living facility expected to serve 84 people in 58 rooms on the western end of Goleta. Old Town Village will provide 14 affordable units for purchase in Old Town, and there is the potential for 132 senior housing rentals at Heritage Ridge off of Los Carneros.
John Fowler, President and CEO of People Self-Help Housing.
Good evening. People Self-Help Housing is grateful to be here today, and we're very pleased to report that we will soon be offering 70 new homes at the Village at Los Carneros. This new apartment community will provide affordable rental housing for low and very low-income residents in Goleta in perpetuity. The average income for each household will range between $42,000 and $52,000 per year. And we'll have units in 1, 2, and 3 bedrooms. The rents will change and will vary according to each household's income and the unit size. On average, rents are projected to be $1,000 or lower per month. These units are expected to be completed at the end of this year. And shortly thereafter, we will be ready to serve approximately 140 Goleta residents. Additionally, under construction in Goleta is the Villa La Esperanza Apartments in Old Town on South Kellogg Avenue. That existing complex is being rehabilitated to add additional units for a total of 83 units. It also includes a new 5,000 square foot community room building for the residents to use. That development is also expected to be completed later this year. And finally, just a few words about what we do at Peoples. We started in 1970, right here on the Central Coast. We're a local community-based 501c3 nonprofit affordable housing developer. Our mission is to provide affordable housing and programs that lead to self-sufficiency for low-income families, seniors, and other special needs groups within our community. To date, we have developed and currently manage over 1,700 affordable rental units for approximately 5,000 residents. Additionally, we've developed nearly 1,200 affordable single-family homes for families who help build their own homes, as well as their neighbors' homes as first-time home buyers. Thank you.
Jennifer McGovern, President and CEO of the Housing Trust Fund.
The nonprofit Housing Trust Fund stands with local businesses and employees who want to have housing in the community. And we finance affordable rental and homeownership housing for low to moderate income working families, single parents, senior citizens, and others in need in the community. This summer, we're thrilled to announce a new program, the Workforce Homebuyer Program, that will offer low-cost down payment loans up to $100,000 to assist local employees in purchasing an entry-level home in the community. Thank you.
Kristen Miller, President and CEO of the Goleta Valley Chamber of Commerce.
Workforce housing is a high priority for the Chamber of Commerce as our members work to provide jobs in the community and those employees need housing they can afford. Our new workforce housing program matches new neighborhoods with local employers by offering an incentive to local workers for new apartments, homes, and condos. We launched this program at Hollister Village and are pleased the Village at Los Caneros and Old Town Village will be participating as well. Hollister Village is our success story, as we can report that 70% of their renters have jobs on the South Coast and 50% work locally in Goleta.
Thank you. And Lisa Prossy, Interim Planning and Environmental Review Director for the City of Goleta.
Good evening. In the past 3 years, 367 housing units have been built and occupied. These are known as the Hideaway and the Hollister Village developments. Further, we have approximately 730 units either under construction or expected to begin construction this year. These developments are known as Citrus Village, Harvest Hill, Cortona Apartments, Village at Los Caneros, and Old Town Village. About 44% of these are rental units, and the other 56% are for-sale single-family homes or condos. In addition, there are approximately 390 rental units working their way through the city's review process. These include 33 additional apartments at Hollister Village and 360 apartments at Heritage Ridge, which is the final phase of the Willow Springs complex. It's important to note that only projects with water entitlements or with previous agreements from Goleta Water District are being processed by the city. Those without water are on hold. We often get asked why the city is approving projects during the drought. The city is only processing applications that have water entitlements. Each of the previously mentioned projects had secured water allocations or agreements with Goleta Water District prior to their Stage 2 drought declaration. The city relies upon and trusts the accuracy of Goleta Water District's determinations regarding a water availability like we do with any other utility provider. It's also important to note that housing under construction now is far more efficient than the typical Goleta housing unit, which was built prior to 1970. The units being built today are approximately 6 times more water efficient than the units built prior to 1970, when most of our housing stock was built. Thank you.
Thank you to all of our panelists. Will you please join me in giving them a round of applause? Well, we want to thank you again for taking time to attend the State of the City. This evening's program will be rebroadcast in English and Spanish on Channel 19. It will be posted on our website at www.cityofgoleta.org, and it will be on our YouTube channel. We hope you'll mark your calendar for the 5th annual Dam Dinner at Lake Los Carneros on August 19th. Look for more information coming out soon, and have a great evening.